Kathleen Ann Duvick was born on November 2, 1937, in Fauston, Minnesota. She had curly brown hair and beautiful blue eyes. Raised by her parents, Carrie and William Duvick, along with their two sisters, Dorothy and Jeannie, Kathleen grew up in a loving and close-knit family. Unfortunately, her father developed Parkinson's disease, which led him to leave his job as an X-ray technician. However, he found a new passion in photography and started his own studios called Duvick Studios. This is where Kathleen's love for capturing moments through photography may have originated. Kathleen attended Fauston's Elementary School with her two sisters. Her mother, Carrie, was a registered nurse, showcasing the family's dedication to caring for others. Kathleen's upbringing in Fauston surrounded her by family, love, and support. Surely shaped her into the compassionate and creative person she became. In her teenage years, our mother was involved in so much. She embraced the words of wisdom from her mother, who always told her, "Kathleen, you can do anything you put your mind to." And she truly took those words to heart, dividing into multiple pursuits. She joined the Girl Scouts, learning many values of leadership. Alongside her sister Jeannie, she learned to play the piano, creating beautiful melodies that filled their home. Our mom's musical talents didn't stop there. She took on the challenge of learning the xylophone. Her dedication paid off when she had the opportunity to play the xylophone in a big school band. She also had the gift of public speaking. Her ability to connect with others through the words was truly remarkable. She devoured every book she touched, consistently seeking to expand her understanding of the world. She graduated in the top 10 of her class. Her curiosity and love for learning was evident in everything she did. Her involvement in her Lutheran church was another testament to her dedication and faith. At the young age of 14, she was asked to be a speaker for the ladies, a role she embraced with grace and wisdom beyond her years. In every endeavor she pursued, she gave her all. Her teenage years were filled with growth and a commitment to making a difference in this world.
Our mother, the nurse. From a young age, my mom aspired to become just like her mom, who was a registered charge nurse, and her sister Jeannie was an LPN. After graduation from Fauston High School with highest honors, the top 10 in her class, she went on to Minneapolis to pursue her registered nurse degree. While working at Northwestern Hospital, she met Richard Dion and started dating, and soon later they were married. She was one of the first nurses to be married while going through nursing school. She had to live on the dorms during the week, and on the weekend she got to go home and be with her husband and also go to church on Sunday at First Baptist Church, where she grew in the Lord as a new Christian. My mom loved being a nurse. She wore her uniform proudly, and she was just a brilliant nurse. She was just so smart. I always was in awe of her with all these big medical words she would have to speak. But God used her in so many people's lives. While family members were in the hospital or in the nursing home, she just always had a smile on her face, a little twinkle in her eye, and such a joyful spirit. And people felt so comfortable knowing that she was going to be the one caring for their loved one. God used her mightily to lead several people to the Lord while they were on their stay, wherever it might have been, at the nursing home or the hospital, and also on their deathbed. God used her to lead many souls to Christ, which we praise the Lord for. He also used her nursing degree as being a mother of seven, knowing how to care for us when we were not feeling well. And as a pastor's wife, not just being a pastor's wife, but also being able to assist church members with knowing what to do if their child was sick. But I just want to say I'm so proud of my mom and just so thankful for her godly example.
Growing up in the Dion home was always an adventure. Mom made it that way. Her smile, her curiosity, cheering each of us kids to reach higher than we thought possible. From a very early age, Mom was involved with education. Mom and Dad attended all PTA meetings. With encouragement, Mom pushed Dad to run for PTA president. Mom was vice president. On one such meeting, I marched in with my Boy Scout troop and presented the American flag. What an honor. With so much worldliness embedded in the public school, Mom was determined to train up her children to follow after God. She was the catalyst in Treasure State Academy. The most important discipline in Mom's life was her prayer life. Early each morning, you could find Mom sitting on the kitchen floor, reading her Bible next to a warm stove. Mom's first concern was the salvation of all her children.
One of the highlights my mom looked forward to every year was the ladies' extravaganza. This was provided for all the ladies in the Mountain States area. I know many ladies' lives were changed as a result of these meetings. My mama first got the vision after attending the Ladies' Spectacular in Hammond, Indiana. She was so blessed and encouraged that she felt bad that the ladies of her church and in the surrounding areas did not have something like this to attend. Mom got so burdened and decided to start the Ladies' Extravaganza. The ladies of Fairview Baptist Church got behind her and helped with decorations and put on a phenomenal spread of food and did an incredible job with welcoming the ladies from other churches. I know for many years, Joanne Wilkins was one of my mom's right-hand ladies in helping with planning so many of these meetings. Many pastors' wives and ladies in different churches were used to speak in different workshops. Julie, Carly, and I were all speakers in different years. I remember loving to look back at all the pictures and the different themes that were used every year. I'm glad my mom had a vision and a burden to help ladies get excited about serving the Lord and teaching them how to raise their children the Bible way. She sure was an incredible lady.
In 1973, my dad and mom founded Church of State Academy as a ministry of Fairview Baptist Church. It was started because of their intense burden for Christian education in the Great Falls area. My mother played an integral role of that ministry for nearly two decades. She served in many roles: teacher, teacher's assistant, reading monitor, wherever she was needed. In 1981, Mountain States Baptist Bible College was started. My mom felt a need to get a Christian degree, so she finished her education, got a degree at Mountain States. She then began to teach English, speech, and sewing. She loved her preacher boys. She was constantly looking for good deals on suit coats so that she could add them to her closet that they called Kate's Closet. She would then let the preacher boys go through it and find whatever clothes that they would need. I got the privilege to have my mom as my speech teacher, where she helped me overcome my fear of public speaking. Two of the greatest qualities of my mom were that she loved and cared for people, especially those in need. And she loved working in the ministry for her Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
If I get there before you do, I'll be looking for you, or I'll just wait till the Lord calls me home. We've had victory and tears, we've been blessed with many years, now we'll spend eternity. And we'll walk hand in hand throughout the promised land, down the streets made of purest of gold. I'm so glad we made the choice. Jesus Christ is still the Lord, and with love I'll be looking for you. heaven's surely worth the wait, just to see inside the gate and to walk on the streets of purest gold. Just to see the one I know who has washed me white as snow. I got a longing now to go. Then we'll walk hand in hand throughout the promised land, down the streets made of purest of gold. I'm so glad we made the choice. Jesus Christ is still the Lord, and with love I'll be looking.
Mother, during her golden years, was just as busy as she was in her younger years. She never knew what it meant to slow down. She was a pastor's wife for over 47 years, and during that time, she wore many different hats. She taught at the Christian Academy, the church college, she taught a ladies' Sunday school class, helped with VBS, she was a soul winner, a counselor, a nurse, and of course, a wife, mother, and grandmother. If there was something to do, she wanted to be there and to be involved. When our father retired from Fairview Baptist, they moved to Colorado. There, Pastor Randall and his people, they lovingly took in our parents and cared for them. So you would think that my mom
might in retirement take a back seat and take it easy. But no, her true desire was to serve and to minister. And so while at Elmwood Baptist, there she helped substitute teach at their Christian Academy. She took classes at their Bible Institute. She loved learning, and she was nearing her 80s at this point. But she said, I just love learning. She taught piano lessons. She took piano lessons. She helped teach a children's class during the adult choir time. She went out soul winning with my dad on Saturdays, so she kept busy. But it was also during this time that others were starting to notice that things were changing about her, and especially her memory. So she was encouraged to go get tested for Alzheimer's, and they did discover that she did indeed have it. This was a devastating blow to all of us children, and especially to our dad. This is the woman that had sat by him in their newlywed years while they were listening to a famous preacher, and she nudged him and said, that's gonna be you someday. And he says that shook him up, because at that time he had a lot of anxiety and he wasn't a confident speaker, and he did not see himself ever being able to get up and speak in front of others. But because she believed in him, he did become a preacher. This is the same woman that spurred him on to start a Christian academy, a college, and many of the ministries during their pastorate at Fairview. So now to go on without the strength or the same strength was very difficult for him. It was an adjustment for all of us, and many, many tears were shed as we saw our mother, our precious mother, slowly drift away. But the part of her that always remained was her ever sweet spirit and constant smile. There wasn't a time you would look at her that she couldn't put on her big, beautiful smile. Proverbs 31:26 says, she openeth her mouth with wisdom, and in her tongue is the law of kindness. This was our mother, even in Alzheimer's. She taught us when we were younger to love the Lord and to serve Him, to redeem the time because the days are evil, and to lay up our treasures in heaven. And now, in her last years, even when her mouth wasn't able to continue to teach us those things, we were still learning. God had us in boot camp. Julie, Jeannie, and myself, Carolee, had the privilege of bringing her in our homes and caring for her. Our children and our grandchildren got to be around her and learn from her and help take care of her. Our amazing, gracious husbands not only allowed us to have Mom in our homes, but also came alongside us and helped us every step of the way. We are thankful that God allowed us to have Mom these many years. And even though Alzheimer's was not the journey we would have chosen, we are thankful that Mom chose to let God shine through her. Thank you, Mom, for being a Proverbs 31 mother. We love you and we will miss you.
And whenever I do die, don't grieve for me too much, because I'm home in heaven with Jesus, and I'll be with Him for all eternity then. And so no need to really grieve, and I've had a wonderful life.